cell phones and distracted driving. So cell phones affect your driving capabilities, whether you're using them for texting, talking on the phone, or even just as a GPS. Listening to a conversation involves 37% of your brain that would normally be used for driving. That's a lot of power because you have to focus on a lot, whether it's looking in your mirrors, you know, paying attention to what's in front of you, stuff like that. So 37% of your brain is very significant. And that's just listening to a conversation, whether they're sitting next to you on the phone. Looking at a screen of the phone while you're driving is even more dangerous because then you're not paying attention to what's going on around you. Texting and driving is, the effects of it are already known. It's been made illegal in pretty much all states. And looking away from the road for 5 seconds at your screen at highway speeds, that's equivalent to traveling the length of a football field. Now, while talking on your phone or like looking at the GPS or something may not be as significant, you're still going quite a long ways during that time. So here are some statistics from 2015, the most recent complete survey by the NHTSA. In 2015, there were a total of 35,000 deaths and about 2.5 million people injured in car accidents. About 10% of those deaths were caused by distracted drivers that were distracted with their cell phones. Now, here's a chart showing the different age groups in relation to their crashes with cell phones. It is very important to make laws prohibiting cell phone usage while in a vehicle because teenagers are among the highest groups of people who use cell phones. Now, teenagers, they have more strict rules that apply to them, so if they get in the habit of not using their cell phone while they're driving now, they're less likely to get into that habit later, which is very important in order to help keep everybody safe. And that is important.